it down the left field line. It is gone!
Live from the downtown Carmi studio, it's the Saturday Morning Sports Show. Live on 97.3 WRUL, 93.3 WROY, and online worldwide at WRUL.com.
Good morning, sports fans, and welcome to the Saturday Morning Sports Show here on 97.3 WRUL and 93.3 WROY. The Saturday Morning Sports Show is brought to you by Little Giant Grocery Outlet, Rice Motor Company, Hell Body Shop, First Med Bank and Trust, Wabash Christian Therapy, Bush & Associates CPAs, People's National Bank, Hamilton Memorial Hospital District, Rush Appliance and Furniture, Citizens National Bank of Albion, Nancy J. Winter CPA, Cherry Street Automotive, Farrell Hospital, Taylor Eye Care, Roark Transport, Wabash General Hospital, and Invenergy, Boomtown Solar. It is our final Saturday Morning Sports Show segment of the fall sports season. Somehow, fall sports season is already over. Chris, basketball starts here in 2 weeks. I don't know how we are already in the first week of November. This year is flying by.
It is just insane. Literally, yesterday, we had to have been yesterday sitting there talking about the Gator Bowl.
Yeah.
You know,
yeah.
And now we're here. Time just, it goes way too quick.
Yeah. Cole Carter alongside Chris Myers, J.C. Tinsley across the hallway getting us on the air. So last Saturday, the Carmi White County Bulldogs had their football season come to an end at the hands of the Athens Warriors by a final score of 48-8. And Chris, really to summarize this game in one sentence, I mean, Athens was a really good football team. We knew Carmi was going to have to play their best game of the season, and that just didn't happen.
No, Athens was just a very, very balanced football team. We knew that, like us, they depended more on the run in the past. You know, they had their own version. They had a 1,200-yard rusher and a player named Corey Craig. But what impressed me about this Athens team is that they threw the ball, again, in critical situations on third and longs, even a couple third and short, slant passes, outs, quarterback escape, which when we recap made just a, you know, Lamar Jackson type play, escaping pressure and throwing a touchdown. They were just a very well-balanced football team, and defensively, they were just like a swarm of bees every time we had the ball. They were a very good football team, and, you know, of course, they're going to have their work cut out for them.
Yeah.
Against
Decatur, you know, St. Teresa,
yes,
later
thank
on today.
You. I was looking for that. I knew that is who the number one seed was. But if they play that kind of balanced football, you know, I think they will, you know, compete with Decatur St. Therese or at least give them a game of some
sort. This is an Athens team who was projected to win the state title in 1A preseason. So take that into consideration. This is an Athens team that was right on the border of 1A, 2A. They get bumped up to 2A, and now they are battling the number one seed in 2A today at 1 o'clock. They'll take on Decatur St. Therese. But I have no doubt in my mind that this team was in 1A, and they could still make a run here in the 2A bracket. But if they were in 1A, there's no question that team is making a run at the state title.
No question. And they have to be thinking, man, how did we get bumped up to 2A? They
got to be thinking. If I'm Ryan Knox and their coaches, I'm upset.
If we're 1A, we would be advancing and we wouldn't be having to face Decatur St. Therese today. We would be, you know, in 1A, our own class, but now we got to. It's like, gee, thanks a lot. This is our reward for winning
exactly.
round one.
Yeah.
So, but, you know, that's how the chips fall when you're borderline on the enrollment. It just depends who wins and where you're at late in the year.
Yeah, and going back to the game back on Saturday, really thought at the end of the first quarter, Carmi was going to have a chance to win the ball game. So definitely did not start that way. Bulldogs forced a punt after getting a first down on their first possession. And Athens needed one play to find the end zone, a 64-yard touchdown run by Camden Austin. The extra point was good to give them a 7-0 lead. And first play from scrimmage, Chris, we're kind of thinking this one might get ugly. But, hey, the Bulldog offense was able to pick things up in the second drive. They had a good kickoff return by Branton Stockton to give him the football around the 40-yard line. And they used the pass game as well. They got the Warriors jump offside on a big 3rd and 4. Very next play, Warren Legg had time to throw and delivered a great ball to Isaac King. King ran the 2-point conversion, and all of a sudden, Carmi's up 8-7, and we're thinking, okay, the Bulldogs got a chance to win this game.
Yeah, it really looked that way, you know, especially what we said couldn't happen did the first drive for Athens. Busted a 75-yard touchdown run, or however long it was, 64 yards, first play, and we're thinking, oh no, here we go again. Mm-hmm. But to the Bulldogs' credit, they responded that next drive and just, got a nice, solid, sustained drive and took it down the field. And then the play-action pass from Legg to Isaac King. You know, what helped make that play go was we had time.
Yep.
Warren, I mean, great job by the offensive line. Draxaw did a good job picking off the blitzer off the edge, and it was wide open. We're up 8-7, and, you know, like everyone in the stadium, thinking, okay, we're going to have a ball game.
Yeah, and it was very apparent that Ethan's defensive plan was to just blitz, and they blitzed the entire game, really, after that pass from Legg to King. He didn't have time to throw the rest of the day, and it wasn't at the fault of the offensive line. It was the fault that we only had five guys blocking, and they were blitzing six or seven, and there's just not much you can do about that when you're a team that – a lot of their passes are through play action, and you need time.
Yeah.
Carmite, they tried to work the passing game. Let's see, Warren threw the ball five times on Saturday. Mm-hmm. But just, again, after that pass to King, just did not have time to throw the ball after that.
And that's exactly what it is, Cole. It's tough when the type of pass you're throwing are dependent on play action, multiple handoff fakes, and teams are just sending the house at you. Those plays take time to develop anyway. And when teams are blitzing you, that you just don't have time. So literally every time Warren dropped back, it seemed like someone was right there in his grill. And, you know, that just makes it tough. So, but again, credit that to their scheme, the way they executed, that being Athens. And, you know, eventually, you know, like we'll talk about after it was 8-7, I know we'll get back into it. We had mentioned, you know, last week, what does Carmine have to do differently than the prior 2 weeks before that had gone bad for him? Well, I had said, and a lot of people agreed, we got to get off the field on third down. Our defense, we can't give up third and 12s, third and 15s. And sure enough, that drive, when we were down 8-7, or it may have been right after that. I think they scored.
They scored their next drive. So it was 13-8. They get the ball back. Yeah. But yes, on that possession, Carmine had, I believe it was the 3rd and 15 that Athens converted, a 4th and 1 near midfield, and they scored in the 4th and 4.
Exactly. The 4th and 4 was the killer. You know, they were around the 10, 15-yard line, and it just seemed like we had at least 4 or 5 defenders right there ready to make a sack, and their quarterback, Cushman, was just a really good athlete, and he just escaped 4 or 5 tackles somehow. And when a quarterback scrambles and your defenders are in the secondary having to cover receivers one-on-one, not knowing where the quarterback's going, eventually the longer that happens, the more they're going to lose track of who they're covering. And he found a wide open I believe it's Corey Craig there in the end zone. And to me, that touchdown, that put him up 21-8, that's the one that kind of just really
shifted
momentum. It kind of took all the energy that was still left in the Bulldogs. Because, you know, if we get that stop, it's 13-8, and it's a game still. You know, we would have the ball deep in our territory. Nothing's guaranteed that we would have took it down, but still we would have had the ball. And things would have been more favorable. Worst case scenario.
At the worst case scenario, you go to halftime down by 5 points.
Exactly. And instead of 2 scores, which, you know, the next series after we go 3 and out, then again, they bust a 75-yard touchdown run. And at that point, for half, you could just really feel the air out of the sails.
And to me, that was the backbreaker. Obviously, the touchdown pass to Craig was brutal because, again, you had all the momentum on the other side. The Carmine fans were getting loud, and they scored that touchdown and made it 21-8. But even down by 2 scores with a whole second half to play, you're thinking,
All's not lost.
Exactly. But Athens was able to use their timeouts. Carmine couldn't get a first down. They punt it. And even after Carmine punts it, you're thinking, okay, just run out the clock and let's go to halftime down by 2 scores. One play, Athens gets a 75-yard touchdown run by Austin. And at that point, that's when it felt like Athens kind of took control. Carmine tried to get a last-second effort before the end of the half. But down by 20 points against a team like Athens, against when you're a running team like Carmine, it was a tough hold to find themselves after 2 quarters.
Yeah, we're a team. If we're down by a score, sometimes it's tough. Mm-hmm. You know, 2 scores – pretty rough odds, 3 scores. I mean, it's, you know, well, what are you going to do? And it was kind of that way at that point. You know, that kind of that sealed the deal at that point. You know, you kind of hoped the Bulldogs maybe could come out and get a stop the first drive of the third quarter because Athens had the ball, but wasn't the case. They took it and just marched it right down the field, got a touchdown with 6:51 in the third, and then the game was basically over at that point.
And again, Athens would score three more times in the second half. Two touchdown runs by Craig, one from 5 yards out, one from 2 yards out. And Jared Schnapp, the JV running back, would score one in from 46 yards out there to end the ball game. Again, the final score, 48-8. Athens gets the win. Carmi has their season end with a record of 7-3, their best finish since 2016. But there's no question, Chris, you and me felt the same way that even going into last weekend and maybe even going into week 9, we felt this was a team that had a chance. You know, if there was ever a Carmi team in the past 5 or so years that was going to have a chance to make a playoff run, it was this team. And you just can't help but feel like, you know, man, this was the team.
Right. When we were 7-0, I think that was everyone's expectation. You know, we knew the Johnson City game was obviously going to be a slugfest, nail biter down to the wire. You know, and again, I keep going back to that game. You know, you stop and think, we were up 22-7.
Yep.
It was almost midway through the second quarter. I mean, we're almost going into halftime with a 2-touchdown lead potentially. You know, and if we could have got a stop up 22-7, we may have had a chance to maybe get punch another score in before half. You know, and two plays, two fullback dives changed that game and
really changed the season.
Changed the season. Yeah. We just, you know, that put us somewhere we had never been. The second half of that game, some missed opportunities. You know, you can, like we've rehashed, you could point at some calls, but bottom line, you know, we didn't get stops against Johnson City in the second half when we needed to, and they managed to. And I just don't think the team ever recovered mentally from that. You know, we came out against Florida the next week. I think all of us thought, okay, we'll shake off the cobwebs, come back, take care of business, and head into the postseason at 8-1. But a Flora Wolves team that we found out after last Saturday was a very game football team late in the year because the Johnson City game, I believe, was 28-20 going into the fourth quarter. So Flora had gave Johnson City all they wanted the following week. So credit the Wolves. But, you know, it just like after that happened, you know, the Johnson City game is understandable. But after we lost the Flora game, it just seems like we just never mentally – you know, got our swagger back. And I think the team's confidence was rattled as much as anything from the defensive standpoint. Yeah. And once teams started stacking the box and when our run did get kind of shut down, it just kind of made the wheels come off the bus, so to speak.
Stat-wise from last Saturday, and really a one-sided stat sheet of that, Athens won the first down battle 23-8. They outrushed Carmi 416-91. They also outpassed Carmi 72-34. Their quarterback, Drew Cushman, was 6-for-6 through the air. Athens did fumble the ball one time, lost it. They did not lose it. Carmi fumbled twice, lost one of them. Of course, that was the only turnover in the game. Athens, this is what's big to me. They were 5-for-9 on third downs. They were 3-for-3 on fourth downs. And really all those fourth downs came, I'm pretty sure, in that second quarter. But there's no question, Chris, especially even in the game against Flora and even the game against Johnson City, if you want to go back that far, this Carmi defense in the last three games just could not get off the field when they needed to.
No, and there were so many critical points. You know, going back to that Flora game, again, I pointed out two of the Flora's conversions were what I call on fluke plays. One was like a 3rd and 10.
Yeah.
It threw a slant pass. The ball got tipped up in the air by our safety and our corner, and you think one of them's going to intercept it. Well, somehow a Flora receiver comes from literally 5 yards away, runs back towards the line of scrimmage, dives under the ball and catches it, keeps the drive alive. Then later on in that game, they throw in a long pass downfield. It got tipped. The receiver is laying on the ground. The ball just lands flat on his stomach.
That's kind of the night that it was for Carmi, too.
When that happened, you knew it was just going to be that kind of night. And, you know, had we gotten him off the field on drives like that, maybe the season's different. You know, especially the Flora game. I think we had him a 4th and 8, maybe 4th and 10 against Flora, and they converted a pass. You know, it just became our Achilles heel. We couldn't get teams off the field on 3rd and long. And if you can't do that, then obviously, you know, you're just putting yourself in tough situations because you're just keeping drives alive, the ball's in their hands longer, and they're going down to score.
Yeah, there is no question that people are now wondering, you know, if Carmi wins that Week 9 game against Florida, who do they play in the first round of the playoffs? But regardless, that's yesterday. And again, the Carmi Bulldogs, their season comes to an end with a record of 7-3. Here's what head coach Kurt Simon had to say after the loss last Saturday.
Coach, we talked about, you know, that they had their own version of a 1,000-yard rusher in Corey Craig. You know, to me, you know, and I'm sure you can attest, how he played defensively. I mean, this team defensively, to me, was very surprising. Their athleticism, especially on the edges in the second level.
Yeah, they Talk were. They about were that. We were having trouble staying on blocks. And, you know, and that's kind of what we've hung our hat on all year is, you know, we feel pretty good about our offensive line and had a couple tight ends we felt like we could, you know, if it was mano-a-mano, we were going to be okay. And they were more athletic than – you know, than we've seen, and they were slipping. We were slipping off blocks and just not staying on them. And then, of course, their linebackers were playing really tight. So when you're trying to do misdirection stuff and you got double teams going to linebackers and they're already on the line of scrimmage, you know, it poses a threat. And but you know, it's not anything that we didn't see before. Matter of fact, we saw the exact same thing last week with it. That's what Florida did to us. Their safeties were just a little bit further back, but. You know, give credit where credit's due. Athens played an excellent game, and they got a good program. And you know, I just told our kids we got nothing to hang our heads for. With the beginning of the year, you know, you always talk about winning enough games to get to the playoffs, and then you talk about possibly winning a conference championship. And we put ourselves in a great position throughout the year to get us to a home playoff game, and you can't take that away from us. And you're not going to find a better group of kids to work with. As far as, you know, unselfishness and coming to work every day, and you don't have to worry about discipline problems, and just fun kids to coach. And hopefully the younger kids paid attention, and, you know, because we feel like we've got some kids that are coming back that will, you know, potentially have a solid football team. But it takes a lot of work. It takes a great attitude, a lot of work, an unselfish attitude, and that's what we preach. And so my hat's off to this group of seniors. I've had a lot of them over the years, and this one is at the top of the list.
Yeah, one of the key things in a senior class in leadership is how you practice your attitude from Monday through Thursday, and you've touched on it. This group you had was one of the greatest attitude-wise, willing to work. Can you just touch on one more time this group of seniors, what they meant to you?
You know, we understand that when you get to the playoff level, that, you know, the Black Diamond Conference is not as competitive as some of these other conferences. I mean, they got Maroa, you know, Auburn, Williamsville. These are people they play every week. So we know that to start out with, that when we get in games like this, you got to pick it up a bunch. But our seniors as a group of kids from when they were freshmen all the way up until now did everything that you asked, and some things that you didn't ask, they did it anyway. That's the type of the young men they were. And I will never, this is always going to be one of the best, you know, enjoyable groups that I was able to coach. And I'm sure they always will be. And you know, it was a lot of fun, you know, and like I said, the way this season went, you know, when you drop the last three, you know, normally if you like to finish with about 5-3, then you might end up losing your last one or whatever. So it hurts hard for these guys, and it's hard to look back. You know, a month ago was when we won our last game or whatever, because it's been 3 weeks since then, and but they have nothing to hang their heads about, and I'm sure they'll all be. And they'll all be successful in life because they, like I said, they have that unselfish attitude and they work really hard and they do the right thing and care about people. And so it's been an enjoyable year. I hope. And I think it's been an enjoyable year for, you know, the community here. So,
yes. And I was going to touch on that. You know, I feel like it's been a while since the community came together like they have this fall. And I think a big part of that has to do with the guys wearing the maroon and white out there. But in general, the seniors and everybody together, what is this 2022 team? How are they going to be remembered by you?
Oh, well, like I said before, just a super enjoyable, fulfilling group to coach, because they always were, you know, eyes were always on you when you coached them. You could Freeman him if you want to. You pat him on the back if you wanted to. You got the same thing every time, and it was an unselfish, hardworking, good attitude kid. You can't ask for anything more than that. From a coaching standpoint, there's nothing worse. And I normally don't even keep the ones around that don't want to act right or whatever. I worry about these guys. And the enjoyable thing is when you watch a good group like this, watch the younger kids, how they react to it. And, you know, so now we get to going back to the weight room, and now you know, the new guys will emerge. And most of the time when you group of seniors like this leaves, you'll see other kids maybe barking the same type of things or whatever. And that's, it's fun to watch from a coaching standpoint, the development and growth of young men.
Yeah, and along those lines, the cupboard is by no means bare. You've got a solid group of juniors coming back that are battle-tested. You know, Nelson Ryder, Gavin Payton, Andrew Dodson, Austin Owen being some of your juniors out there. You've got some sophomore, Eli Bryan, who's got a ton of experience. You got some talented athletic sophomores coming. I've got Trayton Vickers as well. Mm-hmm. So there's a lot to look forward to next season.
Next season? I would assume it will be a little different look next year.
Yeah.
But we feel really good about our younger guys. We feel really good about the development and some of the, like you said, some of our juniors this year and how they came along up front. I mean, we feel like we have a solid line of scrimmage coming back next year. We're just going to have some inexperienced kids in the backfield, but they've got some speed and they've got some ability, and we could be really explosive next year if we do the things we're supposed to do over the off season, but it's been a super enjoyable year. I'm so thankful for the people of Carmi, how they come out and support our team. We have those pregame meals for the kids and people buying food for us and things like that. We're all making memories for these guys, and they'll have a lot of good memories. Although it's sour right now, when you go back and look at it, there's a lot of good things this season.
Well, we've enjoyed it. It's been a pleasure to watch them. Thank you for the commitment to these young men, and hats off on it. It didn't end like we wanted, but it's been a great year, great to watch, and just these young men represent the school and the community well, and thanks for all you do with them.
All right.
Thanks. Good.
So again, the Bulldogs have their season come to an end, 48-8 lost against Athens back on Saturday. Other playoff scores from last Saturday, Decatur St. Teresa shut out Chester in the 16-1 game, 49-0. Pena took down Auburn, 59-30. Fairfield with the upset on the road against Vernon North Mac, 20-19. Johnson City defeated Flora 36-20. And again, that was a one-score game going into the fourth quarter. Vandalia gets upset by Arthur. Lovington Atwood Hammond, 41-34. Shelbyville gets upset by Belleville Althoff, 38-34. And Red Bud defeats Nashville, 34-21. To give us a couple of interesting matchups coming up later on today. We mentioned Athens will host Decatur St. Teresa in the 1-9 matchup. Fairfield will host Pena in the 4-12 matchup today at 4 o'clock. Johnson City now travels to Arthur at 3 o'clock today. And Red Bud will travel to Belleville Althoff at 1 o'clock later on today. In the 3A bracket, actually we'll start with 1A. Cesar Valier is still in it. They are going to travel to Camp Point Central today at 2 p.m. In the 3A bracket, Mount Carmel travels to Tolono Unity at 2 o'clock. That's the 4-5 matchup in the second round. In 3A, I believe that's the only area 3A team still in it. I know in 4A, Carterville, they are going to be at home today against Cole City at 1 p.m. And Murfreesboro will travel to Macon at 3 p.m. So a couple of local football teams still in it. Chris, I think the most devastating loss for Carmi in that game back on Saturday was they lose a great group of 10 seniors at the end of their football career for Carmi. Just a fun group of seniors to watch over the past 2 years.
Yeah, and like Coach Kurt Simon said, they were just their leadership, their work ethic, and their character. It was just one of the best groups he ever had, and they made it fun to watch. And I think when we read the list of seniors there at the end, I may have missed one. I think I did. I'm going to add Jackson Staten to that list, along with the other seniors that may miss at the end of the game. So my apologies for that. But all those kids, all those boys were just, not only on the football field, but they represent the school and the community well. Just a great group of kids.
Of course, most notably out of that senior group, statistically, the best running back in Carmi history, Isaac King. Just want to run down a list of all the records that King was able to break really over the past just two seasons. Of course, these are all thanks to courtesy of Toby Brown. Most points in a game, he scored 40 last season against Flora. The most points scored in a career with 348. Most touchdowns in a season, he broke that this year with 24. Most touchdowns in a career with 50. Most rushing yards in one quarter, he had 150 last year in the first quarter against West Frankfort. Most rushing yards in a season with 1,945 last season. Most rushing yards in a career, 4,216. Most consecutive 100 plus yard rushing games, 19 games in a row. He had 100 plus yards. That streak actually ended in that game against Athens last year. So week one of 2021 all the way to week nine of 2022, he had 100 plus yard rushing games. Most 100 plus yard rushing games in a season with 10 last season. Most 100-plus yard rushing games in a career with 22. Most rushing touchdowns in a season, 22 from last year. And lastly, the most rushing touchdowns in a career with 46. I think that's all of them.
Did you include the kitchen sink? Okay, I was just making sure. Okay.
But I mean, my goodness, literally what a run by Isaac King. I mean, the best to ever run the football for Carmine.
The statistics say it all, you know, and what a pleasure it was to watch him these past couple seasons. You know, it's I've talked about in the past, you know, what it was that made him so good. And first and foremost, you know, it was his work ethic. The things we say it all the time, what makes a good athlete in any sport isn't what they do on game night, it's how they prepare. It's back during the summer in the middle of 100 degree days, lifting weights at the crack of dawn, you know, running extra sprints, you know, doing things when you don't feel like doing them, when no one's watching, when, you know, you just have those days, man, I'm tired, I'm sore, whatever, but I'm going to get through this. I'm going to work harder than I ever have. That's the mentality you have to have. And that's what he brought every week. And all those kids, you know, played their hearts out. But, you know, to me, it's just not so much his physical ability, which he has. Obviously, his leg strength is just mind-blowing. But, you know, the attitude he had in preparation for what he had to do every week, that's what helped lead to his success, along with his teammates doing a great job blocking up front.
You got to think about his partner as well, Draxon Ott. Draxon has put himself in the record book as well. He is now tied for 14th all-time in touchdowns in a season as he scored 16 touchdowns this year. He is also in 10th place for most points in a career with 174 and tied in 8th place for points in a season. He scored 128 points this year. Ott finished the season with 642 yards, 14 touchdowns on 97 carries. So in the past two seasons, I guess you can count Isaac from that sophomore season, the spring of 2021, but in their two careers combined, Draxon Ott and Isaac King combined for 5,242 rushing yards, 88 touchdowns, and what's most important here, 13 wins and 2 playoff appearances. This senior class, Chris, when they came into the building as juniors back in 2021, Carmi was a combined 7-17 in the previous three seasons and obviously had missed the playoffs in those three seasons, including that spring of 2021 season. But in the past 2 years, the Bulldogs were able to go 13-7 and make the playoffs twice, and that's because of this senior group and what they brought to the table over the past two seasons.
Yeah, and we kind of made the comparison. Drax was the Pippen to Isaac's Jordan, you know, in the backfield, and they not only are they backfield mates, but they're best of friends, you know, off the football field as well. And you know, Drax was just what I call a grinder. Mm-hmm. He got you those tough yards when, you know, if it was 3rd and 2 and they're going to key on Isaac, Drax was going to get you three to four yards even that you needed, and he was just a tough runner. And, you know, it's definitely a testament, again, to these seniors, you know, where they have helped elevate the program to, you know. And what you don't realize is when you get a good senior group, obviously, yeah, you're sad they're gone, you lose their talent. But the things they can leave behind to the underclassmen are just as important. When the underclassmen, the freshmen, sophomores, and juniors behind them see seniors that work hard and have good attitudes and do things the right way, it trickles down to them, because they're, you know, the juniors are going to be seniors next year. Like, okay, Now we know what it takes to work hard and succeed. The younger kids see it. So those good things just trickle down. And again, I think that's what they're going to leave behind more than anything is just their great attitudes and their work ethics.
And, of course, I want to tip the cap to all of the offensive linemen over the past 2 years that have paved the way for both Isaac King and Drax Sinod. You know, the senior linemen, offensive linemen this year, Chase Pringle was our left tackle, Bryson Moore at the right guard position. All the offensive linemen, there's no question that what the Carmi offense has done over the past 2 years wouldn't be done without them.
No, and that's the heart and soul of any football team.
Yeah.
The way you win football games is at the line of scrimmage. I don't care what level it is. I don't care if it's junior league football, if it's high school, college, pro. If you don't have linemen that can get it done, I don't care who you got at quarterback. I don't care who's carrying the ball. It doesn't matter. The guys at the line of scrimmage, the linemen, are what win you football games. And the improvement in the Carmi offensive and defensive lines the past couple seasons has been the key reason. You know, those boys up front have gelled together. They played well. They finished blocks. They put forth their effort. You know, I know the last couple of weeks were tough, but that doesn't take away from their effort and their consistency. And that's how you build a football team. It isn't the guys who have the ball in their hands. It's the guys that are doing the blocking. That's why football is the ultimate team sport. You think about what an offensive lineman does. You're asked every play to do a job to make someone else look good. You know, when I coached offensive line, when I played, and I know you were an offensive line, every guy who's played offensive line, you know, the only person that you got an individual battle. Let me say that first. You and the guy across from you, each play, you know who wins. You know who wins the battle. You know, if you got the best of the defensive lineman, you're an offensive lineman, you'll know it. If he got the best of you, same thing. It's a battle. It's an individual battle every play, but yet the individual battle you're fighting determines the outcome of what your team does. So that's why it's so important. You know, and the only people who notice, number one, are you. Number two is probably your coach. And number three is your parents in the stands. Those are about the only people focusing on an offensive lineman at any time in the game. But it's that work that they do. It's the most sacrificial position in sports. It's what they do that makes others look good. So, you know, that's how you sum it up.
And obviously losing a great group of seniors is tough, but as we were talking to head coach Kurt Simon about it last week, there's no question that Carmi is returning quite a great group as well. They have a couple of juniors who started this year and a couple of sophomores who saw some playing time that will be juniors next year. And Chris, especially that sophomore class, they've got quite a bit of guys that can carry the football and that can score some touchdowns. I think this Carmi team has a really good shot of being really in the same spot they were this year. I think they can find themselves in the playoffs again next year.
Oh, absolutely. I've said it a couple weeks ago. The cupboard's not bare by any means. You know, a lot of these juniors, you know, and again, I don't want to forget names, but there are a lot of big contributors. You know, you think on the offense side of the ball, Nelson Ryder at center, Austin Owen playing a tackle position along with Gavin Payton. Gavin was on the defensive side of the ball as well, Trayton Vickers and Caleb Siebers playing corners. You know, Eli Bryant, the sophomore, coming in at tackle. You know, those are just a few of the names. I again, if I leave someone out, I'm sorry. But, you know, there's a lot of talent in the junior class and the sophomore class and the good freshmen coming up. I definitely expect this team to do some good things next year as well.
Also, can't forget Andrew Dotson. Also,
Andrew Dotson, thank you. See, I knew I'd forget somebody. That's what happens when I try to say names.
On the spot. You know, it's hard to remember things on the spot. But, you know, Andrew was a guy that, you know, as the year went on, teams were really focusing in on Isaac and Draxon on. But early in the season, we saw Andrew Burkoff some long touchdown runs. And I have no question he's going to have his fair share of those again next season.
He has some speed.
We'll go ahead and take our first break of the morning. When we come back, we'll take a small preview of what's coming up this winter here in Carmi, right here on the Saturday Morning Sports Show.
Great teamwork is no accident.
David and the gang at Hale Body Shop salute the area athletes.
Just as in sports, the team at Hale Body Shop work together to make sure you get your car back as quickly as possible.
When it comes to collision repair, more and more people choose the team way out there on Possum Road.
Hale Body Shop in Carmi.
David and the gang are proud supporters of area athletes.
Yep, you heard it right.
Citizens National Bank of Albion is this area's five-star and most trusted banking partner.
We make it easier than ever for you to set up a new account.
Take advantage of our mobile deposits and the latest in banking technology.
Sign up for our incentive account, earn cash back, and watch your money grow.
And need a loan for a new vehicle, home, business, or farm?
Come in and talk to our lending professionals today.
Citizens National Bank of Albion, no better banking.
Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
You can buy more of what you want when you save on what you need. Save on meal ingredients by shopping Little Giant Grocery Outlet in Carmi. Little Giant's team of buyers are constantly scanning wholesalers, looking for pantry favorites and meal ingredients at astonishing savings just so you can shop confidently, knowing that you can come in anytime and find great deals from fresh cuts of meat and grocery items to deli, fresh produce, and frozen goods. See just how much more your dollar buys at Little Giant Grocery, Carmi, Illinois.
Miracles do happen. New inventory is rolling in at Rice Motor Company in Carmi, Illinois. I'm Scott Rice, and we have more new cars, trucks, and SUVs in stock since the beginning of the pandemic. New Chevy Malibus, 36 miles per gallon. The hot new Chevrolet Trailblazer. 10 new GMC and Chevrolet half-ton pickups. The all-new Buick GX SUV at 30-plus miles per gallon. Chevy Equinox and GMC Terrain SUVs all in stock now. Hurry, demand is high. Over 30 new Chevys, Buicks, and GMCs in stock now, only at Rice Motor Company in Carmi.
Your family's care team is close to home at Hamilton Memorial Family Clinics in McLeansboro and Carmi. From routine care, vaccines and DOT physicals, to disease management, x-ray, lab work, and COVID testing. With 9 providers and 8 specialty care clinics, Hamilton Memorial has you covered. Plus, for those unexpected illnesses, our weekend walk-in clinics in Carmi and McLeansboro. Hamilton Memorial Hospital Family Clinics. Here for you now, like we've always been.
Ready for cold, snow, and ice?
Me either.
What about your car?
Ready or not, it's coming.
And now's the time to get ready.
Colder temps take their toll.
Heating systems, batteries, and tires all need special attention.
Winterize early and avoid a breakdown in the cold.
Visit Cherry Street Automotive in Carmi.
From oil changes to tire rotation, the pros will make sure your car is ready for winter.
Even if you aren't.
Cherry Street Automotive.
Your partners in automotive repair.
Call 618-382-7165 today.
That's 382-7165.
Taylor Eye Care on Falcon Avenue in Carmi has over 500 eyeglass frames to choose from in stock. Also, a large selection of designer sunglass, non-prescription or prescription. Taylor Eye Care treats every patient like a member of their family, going above and beyond the expected for a truly memorable eye care experience. Call Taylor Eye Care at 618-382-4683 for your next eye exam. That's 618-382-4683. Taylor Eye Care, excellent in eye care.
You and your family have depended on Farrell Hospital for over 97 years, starting when we were just a one-story hospital with 12 beds. As our community grew, we grew to provide more physicians and services. And today, we want you to know you can still depend on us to be here for you with the care and providers you need, right here, close to home. Farrell Hospital. You can depend on us.
Mom is so happy at Wabash Christian Supportive Living. She enjoys herself, loves the food, and I've seen a positive change in her health.
Hi, this is Kathleen Garner, Residential Service Director for Wabash Christian Supportive Living. And if your mom is still independent but missing out on socialization, isn't eating properly, struggles to maintain her household, or just needs daily support, Wabash Christian Supportive Living is perfect. Wabash Christian Supportive Living even offers on-site therapy. As a faith-based organization, you'll both feel confident our actions and conduct reflect your standards. Learn more by calling 382-2900.
Celebrating 20 years of accelerating the clean energy future. Invenergy's Boomtown Solar Project will create up to 400 construction jobs right here in this community while creating enough electricity to power 40,000 American homes. Invenergy expects to invest $60 million in White County over the project's lifetime. Invenergy, innovators building a sustainable world. Learn more at Invenergy.com.
Welcome back to the Saturday Morning Sports Show here on 97.3 WRUL and 93.3 WROY. Cole Carter and Chris Myers, again, our final show here in the fall sports season. We will take next weekend off and then pick things back up on November 19th. And for you, Chris, this can be your last show because you've got some more things on your plate. You're going to help coach wrestling this winter.
Venturing into something I've never done in my life, but just feel honored that Coach Sarge Terry Golson asked me to help, as much as anything. Just hope to have a chance to motivate the kids. And you've got a great group of boys coming up for that, and I'm going to learn just as much as they do, but, we're going to work and have fun. So I'm really looking forward to it. But it's been a pleasure to do this fall with you, Cole. And I think I'm going to speak for what everyone who listens in this community thinks, that you were one of the best at what you do, if not the best. And it's been a pleasure, and I appreciate you letting me tag along with you for this ride these past 9-10 weeks.
Well, I appreciate that. Yeah. I think we're a great team. I think we feed it off each other, and you know so much about the sport of course, coaching for so long. I really wouldn't be where I am or be the broadcaster I am without your knowledge to throw in there as well, so I appreciate it. It's been a fun fall.
Yes.
But Travis Black, good buddy of mine, will be taking Chris's spot for the basketball season, both here on the sports show and during our basketball broadcast. And speaking of basketball broadcast, those begin on November 17th. The girls begin their season actually on the 14th, but I will be out of town that weekend. So they start their season. Our first broadcast for them actually is going to be on the 17th as they travel to Mount Carmel. They then will begin the Harrisburg tournament the following Monday on the 21st. Then the boys start their season on November 22nd, home against Gallatin County. We released the broadcast schedules on the WRUL Facebook page earlier this week. We are doing a total of 14 girls basketball games, I believe 9 of which can also be viewed on the WRUL Sports YouTube channel, and we'll do all 22 of the boys' regular season games, and I believe 16 of those will be on the WRUL Sports YouTube channel. Don't quote me on that, but again, those can be found both on the WRUL Facebook page and the WRUL.com website. Again, just it blows me away that we are already at the winter sports season. Yeah.
I was going to say real quick, though, before we get to basketball, you were right on a few of those playoff predictions. You predicted Fairfield to pull the upset.
Yes,
we're going to get to that in a minute, and Cesar has a good chance. I think of the teams, hopefully one of the Black Diamond teams can advance beyond the second round. It's going to be tough for all of them. I think JC got a surprise having to go on the road, so that's going to be a little different for them. But, even though they're our competitors, they are in the conference, and, we'd like to see them advance, see a Black Diamond team get the third round. But anyway, basketball, we're going to be pretty good, aren't we?
I think so. The boys' team, and I know the girls' team is in a difficult spot. Head coach Clinton Wolf, he graduated 5 starters last year, his 5 seniors. Yeah. So, obviously, anytime that happens, you're going to be in a tough spot trying to find some new players. But he's got a couple of good returners from last season, so that will be a learning process for them. But as far as the boys' team, it's kind of the exact opposite. They graduated 2 seniors, but bringing back 4 starters pretty much. Bryce Connor, of course, returning from his elbow injury. But this is going to be a boys' basketball team that's going to be fun to watch this season. And again, they start their season on the 22nd in that home game against Gallatin County. Once again, they'll take part in the DuCoin tip-off tournament that begins on November 28th. They will play DuCoin on the 28th. They will then play Cairo on the 30th. And then they'll play 2 games on Saturday, December 3rd. They'll play Heron at 12:30 and West Frankfort at 4 p.m. So a chance for the Bulldogs to play some pretty good competition there in the first week of the season to really see kind of what they're going to be like this year. But again, it's going to be an exciting Bulldog team. I think the only question is how deep will they go? We've seen a couple of times in the past Kevin Wolf will go with 10 guys off the bench or maybe just a couple and play a total of 7 guys. But I think he's got some good depth this year. And I think Carmi's, I'll be honest, they're hungry for some postseason success. It's been since 1999 was the last time Carmi won a regional, and kind of the same situation in football. If there is a team for the Bulldogs that's going to make a run, I think it's this team. But I think it's going to be exciting to watch.
Good. Like I say, that's kind of the buzz that they are supposed to be pretty good this winter. So wish them the best, too, both teams, boys and girls.
Absolutely. We'll take our final break of the day. When we come back, we will recap the final Terrible 10 standings right here on the Saturday Morning Sports Show.
When it comes to income tax planning and preparation, experience counts. Experience to know all the deductions that you can take. Experience and knowledge to keep up with the ever-changing tax laws, rules, and regulations. Hi, I'm Keith Butch, and owner of Butch & Associates CPAs in Carmi. For 42 years, I've helped people just like yourself file your tax, auditing, and accounting needs. Stop in today at Butch & Associates on Main Street in Carmi. Call 382-4151 or visit butch.com. That's B-O-T-S-E-H.com.
October is Breast Cancer Awareness Month. In-house mammography services at Wabash General Hospital utilize the latest technology and state-of-the-art equipment in Wabash General's newly remodeled radiology department. Annual screening mammograms are recommended for women beginning at age 40, and no physician referral is required for screening mammograms. Call today for more information, 618-263-6361, and schedule your annual screening mammogram with Wabash General today. People you know, helping people you love.
People's National Bank has two great CD specials for you. A 9-month CD at 2% APY and a 15-month CD at 2.5% APY. Come in today to take advantage of this limited-time offer. Stop by any People's National Bank location and open a 9-month CD at 2% APY or a 15-month CD at 2.5% APY today. People's National Bank, member FDIC. Annual percentage yield accurate as of September 27th, 2022. $500 to open and obtain APY.
Nobody goes into business because they love tedious paperwork, unless you are an accountant. But those tasks are essential to having a successful business. From beginning to end, we can help you with the details of payroll, accounting, and taxes, leaving you free to focus on the big picture. Good at what we do, so you can focus on what you love. Phone 382-2364, Nancy J. Winter, CPA, Cherry Street, Carmine.
Family owned and operated for more than 70 years, Rush Appliance and Furniture stands the test of time. We have a large selection of in-stock furniture and appliances for every room in your home, grills and smokers, and an unmatched dedication to superior service. This is Sean Rush inviting you to visit me in Fairfield or my dad, Terry, in Carmi, where we can help you furnish every room in your house with superb service after the sale.
ProArc Transport in Carmi has earned a reputation of dependable hauling that many in this area have depended on. ProArc Transport now also offers rock, dirt, and lime hauling. From parking lots, driveways, and washouts, ProArc Transport can handle all your rock and dirt hauling needs. Farmers can also depend on ProArc Transport to deliver their lime when and where they need it. For your next driveway or parking lot job, remember ProArc Transport for fast, dependable service. Call ProArc Transport today at 265-3665.
Harvest means long hours and hard work, and planning ahead for what's next. As the third largest ag lender in Illinois, First Mid Bank and Trust has a team of ag professionals who can help you make profitable decisions for next year. Whether you want to add more acres, upgrade equipment, or make seed purchases for planting, our ag lenders can help, because we know how important it is to be ready for what comes next. Talk to a First Mid ag lender today. First Mid is an equal opportunity lender.
For DC Metal, building for life.
Every project starts with the first step. Custom design a new building online at dcmetal.com. Explore their 3D drawings, truss drawings, color selection tools, and a gallery of photos to help inspire ideas. Once you have everything just the way you want, print your final look or request a free quote online. Just visit dcmetal.com.
Building for life, DC Metal.
Welcome back to the Saturday Morning Sports Show here on 97.3 WRUL and 93.3 WROI. Cole Carter and Chris Myers, J.C. Tinsley across the hall getting us on the air. And we are going to recap our final Terrible 10 standings here for the fall sports season. Both of us went 6-4 last week. But Chris, cue the music. He is the Terrible 10 winner this fall by a landslide. He finished with an overall record of 61-29. I finished 49-41. Wasn't the best fall for me in terms of picking, but I've never been good at picking games. That's for sure.
Please hold your applause, everyone. No need to get up.
Did you write down your Grammy speech? Or,
well, I was just more interested in the my reward for winning the Terrible 10, but I think it's just a pat on the back. Bragging rights. There you go. So the proverbial bragging rights. Yeah. So
I will say, and Jason Craig can back me up on this, I asked him, I think you might be the only one who has ever got a perfect 10 out of 10 on a Terrible 10 pick in 1 week. So,
like I say, I've said it before, a blind squirrel finds an acorn every now and then. So,
Well, Chris, we're not doing any more picks since there will be no show next week. And since this is your last show, but I got to ask, big college football game later on today. Number one, Georgia, and number two, Tennessee. Who do you got in this one?
Wow.
I believe the game is in Georgia, if that makes a difference.
It's in Georgia. Okay. Boy, I tell you what, Tennessee's offense is, I mean, they're kind of reminding me of the old Chip Kelly Oregon, just, you know, dropping dimes on everybody. But Georgia plays defense. That's kind of their MO, Kirby Smart. It's at Georgia. But, you know, I just think this is just looking like Tennessee's year. I think the Vols are going to get it done on the road at Georgia.
I agree. I'm going Tennessee here. I think it's going to be an exciting game. Obviously, the game of the year thus far, at least on paper, in college football here in 2022. Before we wrap things up, a couple of things I want to announce in terms of Carmi. Last Friday on the 28th was the Sunrise School Spirit pep session that they did with Channel 14 News. We forgot to mention it on the show here last week. But, Chris, last Friday morning, our high school and our school district raised over 50,000 pounds of canned food goods for the Tri-State Food Bank. And what was a great turnout, a great morning, and a fun, festive day for Carmi County High School. But over 50,000 pounds of food for our Tri-State Food Bank.
Which is incredible. And from what I saw with those results, it just blew everyone else out of the water. I think the next closest school was like 14, 15,000 pounds.
Yeah. And even then, you're getting over into some Evansville schools, which obviously are much bigger than us.
Yeah,
I mean, there's
schools,
no question.
And
that's, not just the high school. That's not just students. That's community members as well. And I'm sure everybody at the high school can say a big thank you to everyone who donated in the past couple of weeks. But absolutely a great turnout, over 50,000 pounds of food goods for our Tri-State Food Bank. Truly incredible. Also want to wish good luck today to Tanner Spence, who is running at the state cross-country meet. He won sectionals last Saturday. He will participate in state later on today. So best of luck to Tanner. Also want to say congratulations to Caroline Simmons and Lucy Stubblefield for being named to the all-conference team in volleyball for this past fall. So a great time to be a Bulldog. That is, I don't care what you say about whatever, but it is a great time to be a Bulldog here in 2022.
It is just a great fall season. You know, football made the postseason. Volleyball had a good season. Golf, all those kids, congratulations. Tanner Spence going to the state cross country. Congratulations, Lucy and Caroline. Congratulations to all you guys. Every single kid participated in a fall sport. Pleasure watching you guys, and congratulations on all your accomplishments.
Absolutely. Well, that's going to wrap things up for us this morning. And again, Chris, I want to say thanks for all the Friday nights and Saturday mornings I was able to spend with you this fall season. Definitely a fun season. I'm already looking forward to next football season.
Same here, Cole. Thank you for everything, and I look forward to seeing you next fall.
Absolutely. And again, we'll have no Saturday morning sports show next week in the 12th. We'll pick things back up on November 19th, right here at 9 a.m. So big thanks to J.C. Tinsley across the hall getting us on the air. For Chris Myers, I'm Cole Carter. Have a great weekend, sports fans.